A very formal welcome to each and every one of you here. And today our topic is digital communication. I would like to rename it as communicate to win. Okay. So ultimately, it is how successfully you use whatever you know, how you use your knowledge. Okay. How you use your knowledge and your skill and your attitude and finally achieve your goal is ultimately is what matters. So here we have this topic, communicate to win. And people, if you look at this communication, we are going to see digital communication ultimately, but you have to understand one thing, that whatever is central, okay, you can imagine it like a solar system. So as of now, digital communication, even to digital communication in a solar system kind of setup, the central portion is your communication. Okay, so if in case I'm going to teach you time management, I would put time management at the center of the solar system, and I would put everything else, you know, around the solar system. But today our topic is communication, so I would like to put communication at the center of the solar system, and all the other aspects in your life around it, because it is from the center you have the power and influence that impacts and inspires the other aspects. That is exactly how I look at it. And believe me, as I said, when I'm doing time management topic, time management would be the center of my solar system. When I am doing leadership, leadership will be the center of my solar system. But one thing that I have strongly felt about communication is that if communication skills and your awareness about communication is at the center of your life, okay, that I've already told you under communication paper, you can really have a purposeful, peaceful, okay, a productive life. That's a fact that I don't want to deny at all, and I want you to get that very, very clearly in mind. If that communication aspect is very strong, believe me, you will get everything else professionally and personally right in your life. And that's exactly what the first slide is. Okay, so here are a few very interesting quotes about communication that I want you to know. It's first is from Peter Drucker, who says, the most important thing in communication is to hear what isn't being said. Okay, that's a beautiful definition about communication, where, you know, they are talking about, the talk is about, don't just hear, listen. Don't just see, observe. Don't just feel, but think. I think it is the higher zone that I've always been talking to you about. Okay, so once again, let me read that. The most important thing in communication is to hear what isn't being said, because not all of us, even if you are a creative writer, you don't say everything, and you don't have to say everything. Few things go without saying. Okay. You know, even without being expressed, when few things are understood, you know, that's very, very beautiful. So under communication, the most important thing in communication is to hear what is not being said. Okay, and what does it mean? Again, I repeat, it talks about not just hearing, this physical part, but about, it's about listening. Okay, it's not just about seeing the physical part, it's about observing. It's not about just feeling part, it's about thinking. So that's exactly what that meant to me. It could mean more to you. Okay, so you can always perceive, you can always comprehend things, and when all our comprehension and perception comes together, beautiful communication takes place. Okay, transfer of knowledge and understanding takes place. The second one is, wise men speak because they have something to say, and fools because they have to say something. I'm sorry to say this, inside a college setup or school setup, you know, it is mostly we find people falling into, why do you call them fools? You don't have to call them fools, but at the same time, you know, you appear as a fool when you are given an opportunity to communicate, but you really aren't convinced, or you don't have anything to share, and there you stand, okay, making a sorry figure. Okay. And wise men speak because they have something to say. So anybody, that's where you become a volunteer. You are a volunteer, you are a leader there, okay? Already so much of idea is there. Suppose I ask you to write something. It's not like, man, what to write? I don't have any idea. I've never got any concept to write. No, it's not like that. Your mind is full of ideas, concepts, you know, it's flooded. And you're just waiting for an opportunity where you could express it, either through writing or speaking, you could express it. And that's exactly, you become wise when your thinking process is sound. And an opportunity you get in a group discussion, okay, on a digital communication platform, your ideas are already intact. All that you need is a pen and a paper or a keyboard to type out your ideas. So just ask yourself a simple question as we move into communication, do communication, and the topic that I would like to give it is communicate to win. And digital communication is just the platform. It's your basic communication that's going to decide your digital communication. And the third quote goes like this: the single biggest problem in communication is the illusion that it has taken place. How beautiful it is, because communication is a process. You have a sender, we would just see that you have a sender, you have the sender encoding the message, you have the message, then you have the receiver who decodes it, then you have the feedback. It's a process. Somewhere you come and drop something. As a sender, you drop something. You have some encoding, you drop something and you go off. You're least bothered about the medium. You're least bothered about the message. You're least bothered about the listener, his decoding of your message, his feedback for your message. Please, please do a very reflective thinking right now as I'm telling you this. How many times you have left your communication abruptly? Least bothered about the completion. It is a circular process. Communication is a circular process. How stupid and absurd it would be when I'm talking to you like that and there you are not present at the other end receiving anything. So, beautiful, you know, George Bernard Shaw. Okay, this great literary figure tells us the single biggest problem in communication is the illusion. Okay, maya. Just this imagination, okay, the communication has taken place where it has not taken place. The fourth point is, like, to effectively communicate, we must realize that we are all different in a way we perceive the world and use this understanding as a guide to our communication with others. I'm always reminded and I always quote Stephen Covey, the author of 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. He beautifully tells us, it is not the problem, but the way you see the problem, okay, that really matters, okay? It's not the problem, but it's the way that you see the problem makes it either a problem or a solution, makes it either positive or negative. So that way, if you look at life, nothing is a problem. Just change the colored glasses that you wear, that you use to perceive things, understand things, okay? So, 2 more quotes, okay? The best speakers in the world are the best storytellers. How beautiful it is. They have a gift to not only tell a great story, but also to share a lot of details that many others wouldn't, okay? Larry Hagner. So, here, any communication, you know, that you do, you become, what am I doing right now? I'm just telling you some stories. Okay, literally I could tell you stories, but I can make my narration itself into a story. So at a PG level, I think obviously today we are seeing your communication is the center of your solar system and you have your complete life revolving around it. Okay, your leadership, your self-awareness, your time management, everything is around this communication skills and that makes it very, very important, okay, and pivotal to your life. And the last one, I think for any relationship to be successful, there needs to be loving communication. Okay, so a 3-step formula for you to be successful in life, okay. So it says a loving communication, appreciation and understanding. even when you're writing on a digital platform, people, it should be something that comes out of you because you care for people. Let's go back to the saying that we read. Wise men speak because they have something to say. You can never become a creative writer. Fools, because they have something to say. You communicate something, you can never become a creative writer. Wise men speak because they have something to say. That's where you become a creative writer, be it on the digital platform or even otherwise. So that's exactly what it says here. That the last one, I think for any relationship to be successful, there needs to be loving communication. What is that you would like to share with the society, with the community? Okay, that would make all the difference for you and for others. What difference for you? You feel happy about sharing. And what difference for others? Okay, that really makes, creates an impact. Okay, I'm doing this topic for English 3, where I was telling them about rhetoric. What is rhetoric? It's rhetoric is the presentation of your ideas, your thoughts, your beliefs, your opinions clearly and persuasively. That is rhetoric. But there's one very important thing. God might have gifted you with great oratorical skills, rhetorical skills. Okay, but are you a good rhetoric or a bad rhetoric? Whatever you communicate, is it creating a positive effect or a negative effect in this community, in the society? Makes all the difference. So, loving communication, number one. Number two, appreciation. Okay, are you able to appreciate the differences? Okay, we are all beautifully different. Are you able to celebrate the differences? And lastly, understanding. Okay, I don't think any communication can take place without understanding your reader, without understanding your listener, without understanding your audience. Because I mean, the minute you communicate, you know, after communicating with yourself, when you communicate with the outer world, it's more about how well you understand the need or requirement of others in your communication. So that is it, people, under the interesting codes of communication. I believe that would have really made a lot of sense to you.